Let's talk about the history of the Tamron Efusion 360. Like any application out there, you can, of course, have an undo. So, for example, if I make a fillet on this edge and hit OK, of course, I can always get back to that. But if I made several operations and I want to do something on an operation that happened two or three steps ago, I mean, the only way to go is delete everything. Not in Fusion. So, here, if you right-click at the far right of the name of the Vision file on the object browser, you have an option called Capture Design History. And the one change you may have seen is that here at the bottom now you have a timeline with a way to play it. So if I now do exactly the same operation I just made, which was do a fillet, simple one here. When I click OK, I have the fillet in here. I can now just for the sake of the example, make a little sketch on this face and have a little rectangle here. And I will now extrude down. Okay, there you go. For no apparent reason, now I have a little pocket in the controller. And as you can see here, after the fillet, I had a sketch and then I have the extrude operation. At any point, I can go back to fillet and I can, for example, say edit feature. And in this case, instead of 2.5 millimeters, say, okay, this was actually 2 millimeters. And it's got smaller. All right, so I can do that as many times as I need. And of course, in here, I can go back to edit sketch. And I will see the sketch, and maybe I just realized that I wanted the edges to be a little smoother, so maybe I want to do a fillet between these faces, these edges lines, I'm sorry. There we go. Finish sketch, and here it is. And not only that, you can also play it back. You can say, okay, what was happening when I was on this stage, or when I was on this stage, right? I have the fillet, or at the end of this. And you can also play it back from the beginning, and just you can also explain how was the whole process of making the model by doing something like this. So again, the history is extremely useful. So since when you bring something from Tinkercad into Fusion 360, the history is disabled by default, it's not capturing it. Remember to right-click on Activate Component. And well, of course, in this case, it's already capturing, so please do not capture design history. But if it's not there, just say Capture Design History and you'll get all the benefits from the timeline.